The biggest challenges that face today's farmers knowing how to deal with the weather and how to compensate for weather-related issues. I'm David Chapin. I'm a rancher and farmer here in Lampasas, Texas. Lampasas is in the Texas Hill Country. And the Texas Hill Country is notorious for its limestone soil, which limits the amount of crops. And also, it's a very well-drained soil, so we lose a lot of water. So it kind of looks like a desert when it's growing natively. And we're trying to raise food crops here. I'm kind of fortunate because I do have an irrigation system, but the question is how much to irrigate, and that's where liquid prep comes in.
I'm Sherry Nguyen. I'm a corporate social responsibility manager for IBM. Water scarcity is real, and it's affecting farming practices all over the world. IBM is partnering with Texas A&M AgriLife through our IBM Sustainability Accelerator to help farmers affected by drought using artificial intelligence.
I'm Gurjinder Bhatt. I'm an assistant professor of digital ag with the Texas A&M AgriLife Research here in Temple. We develop decision support tools for the farmers that can help them in making their crop management decisions, such as irrigation, water management, nutrient management, weed management, and stuff like that.
My first crop that I had after 2 years, we had a hailstorm and it destroyed the crop, and I had no idea that would happen. A couple years later, we had a very severe freeze, and that killed one of my crops. Another thing I had to worry about is the irrigation system had to evolve, because we started with an Israeli irrigation drip system, but the critters seemed to like it and they ate it for lunch, so we had to change to a different irrigation system, and that was pretty expensive and complicated. My biggest issue is I don't really know how much irrigation to feed my trees, and you know what works and what doesn't. I'm still learning, and it's very trial and error sort of thing. If we don't have water, we don't have a crop, we don't have cattle. Cattle can't drink. But mostly, as far as my crop is concerned, the fruit trees, they're mostly drought tolerant, but in a severe drought, they just don't produce anything. Because it's in the hill country of Texas, we're in hills, so some areas need less water and some areas need more. I don't really know which areas I'm overwatering and which areas I'm underwatering. So I just have to take a chance and make adjustments just by eye. That's not always the best way to do it. I need a more scientific approach.
Digital agriculture is the use of technology to help advance farming practices. Right now, what's happening around the world related to climate change is dramatically affecting agricultural practices and farmers, driving many of them into poverty. And at the same time, our global population continues to grow, also putting stress on that vulnerable agricultural process. So using technology, we can help solve these problems. That's where digital farming comes in. Liquid Prep uses an IoT sensor combined with a mobile application that runs on IBM Cloud. This allows us to provide critical weather information through the IBM Environmental Intelligence Suite to help farmers make better decisions about when to water their crops.
So Liquid Prep is an app which can help in irrigation. So right now, in its current form, you can have a sensor, moisture sensor, that you can install into the ground. And once you connect that sensor to your mobile phone, which has the app, you can see the soil moisture on your phone. And you can also download or send the data to the cloud. Now, with our collaboration with IBM, we all research, we are trying to increase its capabilities, because there is a lot of other information to take care of, like weather information, like farmers, they irrigate based on the weather forecast, soil information, because different soil has different water retention capacity, crop information, the crop demands, they differ during the season. So we are trying to integrate all this important piece of information together in this app, so that a more effective, reliable decision for irrigation can be generated, and that so that a farmer can irrigate accordingly.
When Liquid Prep came along, it was like a perfect match for what I was doing. Whereas I need a cheap way and a fast way to look at water usage in my field, in different places in my field. There's some places in my orchard that apparently aren't getting enough water, some places that are getting too much water. And I would learn that from the sensor and from the calculations that and the AI that the that the Liquid Prep app provides. The impact that the app will have on me and my ranch is I'll use less water. I won't have to do it as often, but I'll give the trees exactly the amount of water that they need. So I won't have to pump from my well as much as I do today. So saving electricity in that particular case, saving the reservoir, but also I'll be able to learn how to store the water and how to make sure that the water has the greatest impact for every single tree out there, and also so that they don't die, which was what happened in the recent drought. We lost a lot of trees because I underwatered in some areas.
Yeah, so the farmers, large farmers especially, they have recently some advanced equipments like the planters or auto steer tractors or combines which collect data like yield monitoring and planting, how they are planting. So, but all those sort of data, even though they have access to that data, they don't know how to use that data. And also those sort of data, they can help in building some algorithm or building some tools, but those data cannot be directly used for the farming decisions. So yeah, they have data, but there is should be a right farmer to use that data to make some important farming decisions.
Small farmers are not usually very technologically advanced, and that's one of the critical differences between small farmers and large farmers, and that's where the Liquid Prep app will change the playing field, because people understand how to use a cell phone and they understand how to use some apps, especially Liquid Prep, which is a pretty simple app to operate.
This collaboration between Texas A&M AgriLife and IBM, I see a very diverse team of scientists. Like from IBM, we have data scientists. And from our side, we have modeler, agronomists, which is a very unique combination. Most of the time, data scientists, they work separately. Agronomists, they work on their end. So in this team is coming together and trying to develop this app with more data capability, like AI tools, which is very unique, I would say, and it's going to be great.
The most important difference this will make for communities is vast. I mean, farming practices, agriculture, access to food, affects everyone all over the world. For small farmers directly, this is something, having access to technology is not really something that they have had in the past, but it is the direction we need to move in order to combat climate change and environmental threats. I am really, really proud of the work that IBM is doing with the Sustainability Accelerator. It brings together not only our technology and IBM expertise, but the background and resources of organizations like Texas A&M AgriLife. We can really come together and really grow and scale projects that are going to make a difference.